Endocytosis, as you probably all know, is the process by which the cell takes in stuff, such as nutrients and ions, etc.
Eukaryotic cells take in extracellular molecules through a process called endocytosis, in which the plasma membrane invaginates and pinches off cargo-filled vesicles. This movie shows a series of electron micrographs that have been artificially morphed to show the process of endocytosis as it may occur. The process involves a variety of molecules, including the cargo molecules that the cell takes in, the receptors that capture the cargo molecules, and molecules called adaptins that mediate contact between the receptors and the clathrin molecules that act to shape the vesicle forming at the plasma membrane. In the electron microscope, individual clathrin molecules can be seen as three-legged structures called triskelions. Each triskelion contains three heavy chains and three light chains.
The functional unit of clathrin is known as a triskelion, a three-legged structure made up of three heavy chains and three light chains. Extended interleg contacts between different triskelions allow clathrin to self-assemble into regular lattices. Adaptor protein complexes are able to simultaneously bind to clathrin, membrane lipids, and membrane-bound receptor proteins, and thereby direct the assembly of a clathrin coat around cargo that is destined for internalization. The functional unit of clathrin is known as a triskelion, a three-legged structure made up of three heavy chains and three light chains. Extended interleg contacts between different triskelions allow clathrin to self-assemble into regular lattices. Adaptor protein complexes are able to simultaneously bind to clathrin, membrane lipids, and membrane-bound receptor proteins, and thereby direct the assembly of a clathrin coat around cargo that is destined for
During the assembly of a clathrin coat, the individual triskelions come together, interact through their leg domains, and ultimately form a closed cage.
Endocytosis occurs through complexes of clathrin, which form a basket, and what they do is they basically form vesicles and help the vesicles to pinch off from the membrane. Clathrin itself has a triskelion structure, sort of like a tri-legged structure. So the ones in pink or magenta are the heavy chains, so there are three heavy chains, and there are three light chains. And this triskelion structure assembles into a basket. So here you can see one triskelion. This is another triskelion, so on and so forth. And they basically form sort of like a soccer ball structure. And this vesicle carries cargo from the plasma.
Let's take a look at clathrin-coated vesicles. These are these vesicles are surrounded by coats made from two types of multimeric proteins. That just means that multi means obviously many, several, and meric means part or piece. So there are many pieces to these protein coats. The two main components here are the clathrin molecule and then a variety of different adaptor proteins or AP proteins. So the shape that the clathrin proteins form and the way they assemble around the vesicle as it forms provide the driving force to turn a flat planar membrane into a vesicle, into a spherical vesicle. So the basic unit of clathrin structure is called a triskelion. This is one of these wonderful words that we come up with every now and then in biology, a triskelion. Each triskelion is a multimeric protein composed of three heavy chains, like you see here on the left in red, and then three light chains shown here in blue. And you can see that the heavy and the light chains radiate from what's called the central vertex. These triskelions then assemble into the hexagons and the pentagons that you see in a lattice that forms around clathrin-coated pits and on the vesicle surfaces. So you can see individual triskelions. Here's one in red, here's one in yellow, here's one in green, lots in blue. And so you can see how these assemble to form these complex multimeric shells. And it's that shell which gives you the targeting. It gives you the prevention of fusion with other membranes, and it induces membrane curvature.
Here you can see the cargo molecules in red bind to the transmembrane cargo receptor. So this is the outside of the cell, and this is the inside. So cargo from the outside binds to the transmembrane cargo receptors, and the cytoplasmic domain of these receptors bind to a protein called adaptin, shown in light green, which then recruits the clathrin. So the clathrin here is shown in dark green. And then the clathrin actually keeps on binding to these receptors to form a cluster. And as they form the cluster, they induce a curvature to the membrane and eventually will form a clathrin-coated pit. Here you can see that this vesicle contains the cargo, the receptors, and then you can see the clathrin coat on the outside. So as the additional clathrin molecules bind, they increase the curvature of the vesicle. Now this vesicle needs to be pinched off. How does this get pinched off? Well, there's a protein called dynamin. And dynamin assembles a ring around each clathrin-coated pit or vesicle. And what happens is that this ring constricts to pinch the membrane.
The receptor-mediated endocytosis, which is where the cell's receptor detects cargo molecules on the outside, and through the help of adaptins, which helps in specificity of the cargo, the cell can take in the cargo molecule. In this case, a protein is detected by the receptor. The membrane then forms what's called a coated pit, where it slowly invaginates the substance as well as the receptor. Here we have the membrane with the cargo receptors and the adaptin attached on the inner membrane part of the receptor. And here we have the cargo. On the inside of the cell, we have lots of clathrin proteins. The cargo will bind to the cargo receptor, which will then cause the adaptin, A2 is the most common adaptin in humans, to recruit accessory proteins, which will then help in recruiting clathrin protein. So the clathrin will start binding with each other to form hexagonal type shapes, things which will eventually pull part of the membrane in, forming a coated pit or a clathrin pit. More clathrin are still recruited and it just gets built up. This again causes the membrane to sink partially in, taking in the receptor and all that in that segment of the membrane. The clathrin protein continues to attach with each other, slowly forming a sphere-like structure. Dynamin also begin to attach to where the endosome is being formed. Finally, when the vesicle is ready to be pinched off, dynamin will form a helical structure around it, and using energy from GTP, dynamin will break off the endosome, freeing it into the cytosol. Thank you.
Thank you.